Good morning. In the last lecture, we have seen the binary search tree and some of the examples on designing a binary search tree for the given list of elements. Today, we are going to study about the AVL tree in data structures. An AVL tree is a height balanced binary search tree. It is named after their inventors Adelson, Wilsky and Landis. That's why this tree is called as AVL tree. Any binary tree is called AVL tree if and only if the balance factor of every node in that tree is in the range of 0, minus 1 and plus 1. A question may come in your mind that what do you mean by a balance factor of a node? So the balance factor of any node can be calculated by the formula balance factor equal to height of left subtree minus height of right subtree. And in our first lecture, we have already seen the definition of height of the tree. A binary tree in which the balance factor of any node is more than one is called as imbalanced tree. There are certain rules to balance the imbalanced tree. So a question may be asked in the examination that how to balance an imbalanced tree and convert it to AVL tree. We use the following rules to balance the imbalanced tree. So the first rule is about single left rotation. So while designing the AVL tree, a structure like this may comes into the design of AVL tree. So here if you see, the balance factor of node C is 0, leaf node is 0, because there is no left and there is no right child to the node C. That's why there is no left height and there is no right height. That's why it is 0 minus 0 is 0. The balance factor of node B is calculated as height of left subtree minus height of right subtree. If you see to node B, there is no left subtree. So the left height is 0, whereas right height is 1. So 0 minus 1 is minus 1. For root node A, the balance factor is minus 2, because if you see, there is no left subtree towards left of A, but there is right subtree having two levels down. So that's why the total height is 2. So 0 minus 2, the balance factor of node A becomes minus 2. Now if you see in this diagram, the tree is imbalanced at root node A by the negative balance factor. Remember one thing, that is, if the tree is imbalanced because of negative balance factor, we need to take left rotation. If the tree is imbalanced because of the right, because of the positive balance factor, then we need to take the right rotation. In this example, we have to take single left rotation, because if you see, the tree is imbalanced at root node A having minus 2 balance factor and it immediate children towards right is having minus 1. It means the signs are same. If both the signs are negative, then we take single left rotation. The parent node and its child having the same negative sign balance factor. That's why it is single left rotation. After single left rotation from A, if we do that, B, after that B becomes the root node, A goes to the left subtree and C goes to the right subtree. And then again, if you recalculate the balance factor of node A becomes 0, because it is a leaf node. There is no left and right child. Similarly for C also, the balance factor is 0. For root node B here, the left height is 1 and the right height is 1. 1 minus 1 is 0. And it is in the range of AVL. That's why this diagram is called a AVL tree. Previous diagram was not a AVL tree. It was imbalanced and this is now a balanced tree. The rule 2 in AVL rotation is about single right rotation. Now when to take single right rotation in AVL tree creation? If there is a structure while designing the AVL tree comes like this, a tree which is growing on the left hand side only. If you see, the balance factors of node C here is 0, node B is plus 1, because there is left height but there is no right height. So 1 minus 0 is plus 1. For root node A, the balance factor is plus 2, because the left height is 2, whereas there is no right height. So 2 minus 0 is plus 2. Now this tree is imbalanced at root node A here, having balance factor positive 2, whereas its child is having positive 1. The sign of parent as well as child balance factors are same. So in this case, the tree is balanced because of positive balance factor. So we need to take the single right rotation from root node A. After rotating the tree from root node A, the diagram looks like this. A goes to the right part, B becomes the root node, whereas C goes to the left part. If you recalculate the balance factors now, the balance factor of C and A becomes 0, 0, because these are leaf node and no left and right child to it. For node root node B, there is left height 1 and there is right height 1. 1 minus 1 is 0. So if you see, the balance factor of all the nodes into this diagram are in the range of 0, 1 and minus 1. So that's why it is called a AVL tree, and the previous tree was not an AVL tree. Now let's see the third rule. It is about the double rotation and when to take double rotation, that we'll see. The rule is also termed as left-right rotation into the AVL tree. We have to take left-right rotation only when this is the structure, if it came into the AVL tree design. If you see in this diagram carefully, the node C has balance factor 0, node B has minus 1 because there is no left head, only right head is there. So 0 minus 1 is minus 1. The total balance factor of node B is minus 1. Its root node A, the balance factor of root node A is plus 2 because there is only left height and there is no right side. So no right height of the root node. So 2 minus 0 is plus 2. If you see in this diagram, the tree is imbalanced at root node A, having balance factor positive 2, but its immediate children is having minus 1. So if you see, the signs are different. Opposite signs are there, correct? So whenever there are opposite signs, we have to take a double rotation. In case of double rotation, we have to first balance the child and then you balance parent. Now if I try to balance this child here, I will first check what is the balance factor, whether it is positive or negative. If it is negative balance factor, we have to take single left rotation from B only. Do not touch A in this case. So we are only rotating a tree from root node B towards left hand side. So we take single left rotation because of negative balance factor here. So whenever we take single left rotation here, C becomes root node and B goes to the left subtree of node C. Now if you recalculate balance factor here, the balance factor of node B is 0, node C is plus 1, whereas node A is plus 2. Now if you see, the root node and its immediate children is having positive balance factors and the tree is imbalanced at root node A. So we have to take single right rotation from root node A. After rotating this diagram, we'll get this diagram where the root node is C. A goes to the right subtree of node C, whereas B is towards the left hand side. If you recalculate the balance factor here, the B and node A are having balance factor 0. Node C having balance factor 0 because there is left height 1 and the right height is 1. 1 minus 1 is 0. And now if you see the balance factor of every node in this diagram, all are in the range of 0, minus 1 and plus 1. These are allowed for AVL tree. So I can say that this is an AVL tree and the first diagram was not in the form of AVL tree. It was imbalanced, and this is the balanced tree for the same diagram. Now the next rule is, again, it is about double rotation. Rule number 4, we have to take this rule only when there is a structure like this in the AVL tree creation. And the rule is termed as right left rotation. Here also we apply two rotation, that is, first is right rotation and then left rotation. Now you just focus on the diagram. Here is the balance factor of node C is 0, balance factor of B is plus 1 because there is left height 1 but there is no right subtree, that's why 0. 1 minus 0 is plus 1. The balance factor of node A is minus 2. Here there is no left subtree but there is only right subtree, 2 levels down, that's why 0 minus 2 is minus 2. Now if you see in this diagram, the tree is imbalanced at root node A because of minus 2 balance factor. and its immediate children is having plus positive balance factor. Opposite signs. Whenever there are opposite signs, we have to take double rotation. Now, whenever we take double rotation, we first balance the child node. After that, we balance parent node. Now, in this case, we take single right rotation from node B. When we rotate it towards right, C becomes the root node, B becomes to the right node of the node C. If you recalculate balance factor into this diagram, node B has the balance factor 0, node C minus 1, and node A has minus 2 balance factor. If you see, root node has minus as well as is immediately having minus balance factor. So if the signs are same, we have to take only single rotation. Because of negative balance factor, we have to take single left rotation. So from A, we take single left rotation here. After taking single left rotation, the tree looks like this. If you recalculate balance factors here, all are having 0, 0. So we can say that this is the AVL tree for the previous diagram. Now there are two more miscellaneous rules that I have designed to understand some tricky points while designing the AVL tree. Rule number 5. If you see this diagram here, suppose this structure comes into the designing of the AVL tree. If you recalculate the balance factors here, all are having, leaf nodes are having 0, 0, 0. Node D is having balance factor 0. Node B is having plus 1. And node A is having plus 2. If you see node A plus 2 balance factor, because there are 3 levels down on the left hand side. The left height is 3 and the right height is 1. 3 minus 1 is plus 2. Now if you see, the root node is imbalanced here because of positive balance factor. Its immediate children is having plus 1. Signs are same. It means we have to take single right rotation. If you take single right rotation here, node B becomes the root node. After that, towards left we have node D. Towards A, right we have A. F and G will go to the left and right subtree of node D. Node C becomes the right part of node A. But what about the node E here? So the statement that we have written in the first line of AVL tree is, it is height balanced binary search tree. Now we'll apply that binary search tree rule here. If you see node E here, it is less than node A. That's why it is kept into left subtree, but it is greater than node B. So if it is greater than node B, it must go to the right subtree of this diagram. Okay. So, but it is less than node A. So we have to place node E here only. So this is the correct place for node E after single right rotation for the previous diagram. There is one more miscellaneous rule, that is rule number 6. Similarly, similar type of structure is given here. If you see, the leaf nodes are having balance factor 0, node E is having balance factor 0, node C is having balance factor minus 1, node A is having balance factor minus 2. Now this tree is imbalanced at root node A and with negative balance factor. It means we have to take single left rotation from root node A because its children is having also negative balance factor. Both the signs are same. That's why we take single left rotation. After taking single left rotation here, C becomes root node, A go to the left subtree, B towards the left of node A. Towards right we have E and F to the left and G to the right. What about node D in this case? Where to place into the tree after taking single left rotation? Here we have to apply the binary search rule. If you see in this diagram, D is appearing on the right side. It means it is greater than node A but less than node C. If you apply the same thing here, it must be less than node C. It must be placed to the left subtree. But it is greater than A, that's why it is placed to the right subtree of node A. So this is the correct place for node D. Okay. If you recalculate the balance factor now in this diagram, all are having 0, 0, 0. So it is in the range of AVL. I can say that this is the correct AVL tree for the previous diagram. Okay. So once we understand all the rules, we can solve any problem for AVL tree creation. We'll see in the next video lecture a problem on AVL tree. Thank you for listening this video.